The hands of time turn swiftly as progress in saving lives marches on. Join us on a journey through the history of CPR. Our story begins in 1740, as the Paris Academy of Sciences recommends mouth-to-mouth resuscitation for drowning victims. More than a century later, Dr. Friedrich Maass performs the first documented chest compressions on a patient. Then in 1903, Dr. George Kreil reports the first successful use of external chest compressions to revive a patient. Another step forward is taken when Drs. James Elam and Peter Safar modernized the technique for mouth-to-mouth resuscitation. Just a few years later, work begins on the Resusci-Anne mannequin, developed by Asmund Lærdal, Dr. Safar, and Dr. Bjorn Lind. The training aid is introduced in 1960. That same year, CPR itself is developed. And CPR is formally endorsed by the American Heart Association in 1963. 3 years later, the first CPR guidelines are published by the National Academy of Sciences National Research Council. Then in 1972, the world's first mass CPR training program begins in Seattle, certifying more than 100,000 people in the first 2 years. Not long after, 911 operators in King County, Washington, begin giving CPR instructions over the phone, a practice now in use nationwide. And in 1983, the American Heart Association convenes a national conference to develop CPR guidelines for children and infants. The decade of the 1990s sees the start of programs to put automated external defibrillators in public places. And in 2005, the American Heart Association developed CPR Anytime for family and friends, allowing anyone to learn CPR in just 20 minutes. Then in 2008, the American Heart Association goes on to introduce hands-only CPR. Today, we stand on the threshold of new progress in CPR. Techniques will be further refined, more people will be trained, and more lives will be saved as the history of CPR marches on.